Mueller and this memo.
Yes.
You know what's in it. What's in it?
Yes. Well, essentially what you have, I think, is evidence of the single largest political scandal in American history. In essence,
that's a lot. That's
the Obama administration utilized the authority and power of government using a totally phony rationale to conduct political espionage on the Republican candidate for president. Watergate rather pales compared to this. They knew that this was false. This memo, the dossier, as it were, mm-hmm. is like a hot potato who goes from hand to hand. Mm-hmm. Paul Singer paid for the original iteration in an effort to help Marco Rubio against Donald Trump. When that failed, the boys at Fusion GPS, being real capitalists, essentially resold this thing three times. Mm-hmm. The Democratic National Committee and Hillary paid for it. The Republicans and Singer paid for it. And the FBI ended up paying for it. Mm-hmm. The problem is that it's false. So in July of last year, the lawyers for the Obama Justice Department, on behalf of the NSA, went to the FISA court and asked for warrants to surveil yours truly, mm-hmm. Paul Manafort, Carter Page, who I think is just kind of a hapless dope who got in the way, and to their shock and surprise, because the FISA court is a rubber stamp and they give the government anything they want, by the way, they don't have to have probable cause. They can just say, we want to look at Milo because we want to. And
we
the judge will
like
usually
it.
Say yes.
Yeah.
They were shocked when the judge turned them down. So they waited 2 months. They went in front of a different judge. They never told that judge this had already been rejected previously, and mm-hmm. it was ultimately approved. Mm-hmm. How did we rationalize this? Oh, the dossier. Trump was in bed with the Russians, therefore we need to watch his people. Mm-hmm. The whole thing was bogus, but it encompasses Mueller, Comey, McCabe, Rosenstein. I mean, it stinks to high heavens. And now all the dots have been connected. The people who I really think deserve credit here, enormous credit, are Jim Jordan and Matt Gaetz and Ron DeSantis and Trey Gowdy. The rest of the country club Republicans are over at the cocktail party and they don't want to rumble. These four guys have busted this wide open. And just think how horrible it's got to be to sit in the same room with Adam Schiff every day, day after day. I mean, it just must smell like Schiff. Or as I like to say, if it's Schiff, flush it. This guy is the worst phony I've seen in public life. He recently sponsored a sense of the House resolution mm-hmm. that declares that no American has ever been injured by a vaccination and the U.S. government has never paid out a dime in reparations for such injuries, when in fact we've paid out $3.5 billion so far. Mm-hmm. But he has to pander for big pharma campaign contributions. Really, this guy is beyond belief. He's the Sammy Glick of the Democratic Party.
So what happens when this inevitably leaks out, becomes public, ends up, you know, top of Breitbart, tweeted around? What are the next 48 hours look like?
Well, it's an interesting question.
Because if this really is that, if it's as big as you say it is.
If you really had an attorney general who wasn't comatose, you would have, most of these people would be arrested and they would be charged, tried, convicted, and jailed.
You have to wake him up.
It's conceivable that Jeff Sessions actually passed away several years ago and nobody told him about it.
No one knows.
I mean, this guy is so boring, he dyes his Easter eggs white. But he's, in all honesty, he's so obsessed with cracking down on state legalized marijuana that these people are stealing the Constitution right out from under us. And he told the Senate committee he couldn't investigate Hillary Clinton because he couldn't find anything to investigate it. This guy has got the visual acuity of Stevie Wonder.
Joining us now, Republican Congressman Sean Duffy and Congressman Chris Stewart, who have both reviewed the memo. It's great to see both of you gentlemen.
Hey, Laura.
Boy, you guys have to work now for a living. You're working Friday nights just like I am. I mean, you guys
like
need to go home on the weekends. Everyone's in town, so it's good to see you both.
Is, Laura, we're probably working tomorrow and Sunday, too. You get to go home. We don't.
Poor baby. I'm going to get my violin out for you, Sean.
Thanks.
You've cut enough wood in Wisconsin this season
anyway.
You don't have to cut anymore. Let's talk about what you saw in this memo. I know you can't discuss it. It's classified. However, 140 of your fellow members have seen it, only one Democrat. Does that surprise you that Democrats have such a stunning lack of curiosity about its contents?
Laura, I'm going to jump in on this if you could. Not only have I seen the memo, but as a member of the Intel Committee, I've been aware and have been helpful in creating this memo. And to answer your question, let's back up a little bit if we could. For the last more than a year, we heard one thing, collusion, 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 and then we didn't. And then we heard obstruction, obstruction, and then we didn't. And the reason being is there was no evidence for that. But this is what we do know, the second story now. We know that Hillary Clinton and the DNC hired Fusion GPS, that hired a foreign agent who used foreign assets, including more likely Russians, and created the dossier that we know is garbage. And the question now is, did the FBI use that to before the FISA courts? Were they honest in how it was presented? And did the FISA judges exercise the prudence they needed in questioning this material? That's the focus of this memo.
And Laura, and Sean, if I could add on to that, the bottom line is this doesn't fit the Democrat narrative that Donald Trump colluded with Russia. And so if it doesn't fit the narrative, they don't want to see it because they're not looking to find the truth. They're looking for a pathway to destroy Donald Trump. And listen, I don't think it's helpful for Republicans to froth at the mouth with what's in this document. I was deeply disturbed. I think there's serious issues at the top of the DOJ and the FBI, which is, Laura, why they didn't want to give this information to us. It took us 4 months and threat of congressional action to force them to give us the documentation. Once I've looked at it, I know why they didn't want to give it to us. But also, I got to say, there's also, and we've heard someone may be prosecuted. I would agree with that claim. But again, America wants to hear the truth. We don't want the Democrat narrative. We want the truth. And that's why movement to expose the memo is gaining steam. And I think, frankly, the Intelligence Committee will have a vote. They will release it. Donald Trump will clap his hands and say, let's expose what the Obama administration was doing with the DOJ and FBI.
Remember Barack Obama back, and I think it was the fall of 2016, I believe. He basically poo-pooed the idea of any politicization of the intel community working against Donald Trump. He said, I can guarantee you that didn't happen. Similar things said by Susan Rice and other members of the National Security Council that would have had access or requested access to the unmasking of individuals who had been surveilled under the FISA warrant that was filed and granted. So they're saying this is a Republican pipe dream that you guys just don't want to answer the real questions about what happened in this with any dealings with Trump and Russia. They just deny it.
That's just silliness. This investigation has been going on for more than a year. I was in Moscow just before the election, and I came home and said 100 times, they're going to mess with our election. It was clear that that was their intention. This committee, this investigation has asked every question. We've interviewed dozens and dozens of witnesses, thousands of hours, but the facts are just the facts. And if the bottom line is, if you've made these accusations and at the end of the day there's no evidence, you have to consider the alternative. Maybe these people are innocent. And by the way, they weren't accused of stealing bubble gum. They were accused of treason. And to be fair to them and to be fair to the process, you have to be willing to say, maybe the accusations we've made aren't true. But then, now, what we're looking at, you have to be honest as well and say, these are incredibly troubling revelations. And by the way, it's not just FBI and DOJ. There's information regarding the politicalization of the CIA that, to me, is at least as troubling. And we hope the American people know that as well.
Well, you know, and both of you know this very well, but there were a lot of warnings about what was going to happen if Trump was elected going back to August of 2016. There was a big piece, I remember, I think it was a National Review. I just tweeted it out for people to read, that they were setting him up at the time, and this was a former intel officer who worked for 25 years in the intel community, wrote this piece, and it was basically a warning that people who say intel is never politicized, they haven't been around, they haven't seen recent history over the past like 50 years or so. So that's one thing. I want to play for you, to both of you, an interview that Catherine Herridge of Fox did. It's not getting enough attention, frankly, with Natalia Velitskaya, who is that Russian lawyer who was at that now infamous meeting at Trump Tower that got so much publicity. And she asked a question about, you know, what was the meeting like? What was the purpose of the meeting? Let's watch.
My meeting was not tied at all with Hillary Clinton or anyone involved with any Democrats. The Democratic bloc insists that I was some kind of an agent of the Kremlin.
I did not collude with Russia.
The president's son-in-law barely attended, according to her account.
He came after the start of the meeting and left before it ended, so we didn't even look each other in the eye.
Well, apparently she has not been called to testify, get questions from the Mueller team yet, and Congressman Duffy. You know, look, you know, you don't know whether to believe her or not believe her, and I was just trying to see if I could understand the Russian in that little clip, and I pretty well could understand it. But tell us what you thought about that.
Well, first, I don't speak Russian. Maybe you do, Laura. I listened to it, and I would say that's exonerating the Donald Trump campaign, saying, listen, I had nothing to do with Hillary Clinton, and I wasn't trying to put undue pressure. I was talking about basically a different issue
with
Magnitsky the Trump campaign.
Act. Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. But if Democrats hear this, they'll say, oh my goodness, this is further collusion between Donald Trump and the Russians. They're trying to give Donald Trump an escape hatch by sending her out and saying there was no collusion here. It's just the way they'll read every different piece of evidence. Can I just make one other point,
sure.
Laura? We give incredible powers to the FBI and the DOJ, and we want them to keep us safe, especially after 9/11. And we're okay giving that power as long as they use it in certain guardrails. And they respect people's Fourth Amendment rights. But when they step outside the boundaries with which we set up for them,
yeah.
and they use it for nefarious purposes, that's when the American people get riled up. And that's why it's so important that the memo come out. The only way we're going to change the way the FBI and the DOJ works is when the American people know what they're doing. And so then the partisanship isn't there, but the American people have the truth, the facts, and can say, we have to change this.
And Congressman Stewart, Congressman Duffy, we just learned that the procedural vote in the Senate failed. So it failed to avoid the government shutdown. That's where we are thus far. Every indication was that that's the direction it was going in. But we have definitive word that indeed that procedural motion has failed, meaning we'll at least have a temporary shutdown of the U.S. government. Non-essential employees will not be paid, at least for the time being. They usually are paid afterward. So we'll keep track of that for all of you. One thing I want to do for you, Congressman Stewart, is have you listened to something that Congressman Adam Schiff said earlier today. Oh, it's actually a full screen, excuse me. He said this about all of your comments about this memo. He said, a profoundly misleading set of talking points drafted by Republican staff attacking the FBI and its handling of the investigation. This is meant only to give Republican House members a distorted view of the FBI. This may help carry White House water, but it is a deep disservice to our law enforcement professionals. Adam Schiff. He's saying that you guys are the ones making it more difficult for law enforcement and our FBI and our intel community to actually operate. And I guess that's for you, Congressman Stewart, since Congressman yeah. Duffy is not on the committee.
Well, it's just nonsense. And I had this conversation with Mr. Schiff just a few days ago. And let's be clear about one thing. When we talk about DOJ or FBI, we're not talking about the body. We recognize these are dedicated public servants. We're talking about a few of the very senior officials within the FBI and DOJ. But the fact you work for the FBI doesn't mean that no one in that organization is above question, that none of them are above reproach. We have a responsibility to provide oversight, and when they do something unethical and potentially illegal that violates the trust of the American people, for heaven's sakes, we have a responsibility to pursue that. You can't say, well, you can't attack the FBI, you can't attack DOJ. That's just silliness. And by the way, when he refers to us for protecting Mr. Trump, that's the thing that I react to most emotionally. It's just simply not true. It's just a diversion from the fact that we've seen things here that trouble us.
All right, well, Congressman Duffy, before we let you both go, I'd ask a very simple question. Rod Rosenstein is the Deputy Attorney General. He was named Deputy Attorney General by Jeff Sessions. Jeff Sessions recuses himself from the Russia investigation. Rosenstein, he's the man in the hot seat. He's playing hot potato with this whole thing. He's like, I'm not doing it. I'm going to do a special counsel. It was just an idiotic idea on his part. Sorry, but it was. And my sources are telling me that he is vulnerable in this report, and given what we learned about an extension of a FISA warrant. Can you tell us anything about that, Congressman Duffy?
I can't make a comment on that, but what I can say is Rosenstein has been not cooperative. He's one who's helped stonewall the Congress. It took us 4 months to get these documents. I think if you want to clear the FBI, if you want to clear the DOJ, be transparent. Show us all the information that you have. Yeah, well, but even beyond that, there's
beyond
more
that.
Information, and if we're gonna fully investigate what they've done at the DOJ and the FBI, we need fair partners to work with us, and I don't think Rosenstein has been that fair partner.
Well, if he's not giving you the information, the question is why? No, if national security isn't implicated, why can't the people get this information out there? Then clear the air. If everything's fine, everything's copacetic, it's fine.
Yeah. You will get the memo. You're gonna see it. I think the Intel committee will vote on it, and you'll have a chance to see it, and so too will America.
Fantastic.
Just not tonight.
Well, yep. We're itching for it. And the hashtag, #ReleaseTheReport is still trending on Twitter. Guys, thanks so much. Now
we have to have the Schumer shutdown trend as well.
Oh, the Schumer? No, we're already doing that. Come on. Right. Give me some credit here, Duffy.
All right,
guys. Well, I'm sorry you have to stay up late at night, but, to give another cup of espresso. Do something to keep yourselves up.